I grew up in Chester, Pennsylvania. They get to ask him, they tell you why they came to Detroit. And the little town called Wilmington is about 15 miles from us. And every Monday, I would go there and with my father and a couple of musicians from Philadelphia, and they would rehearse. It was I call it a circus band because it was a small group of, let's see, it was three clarinets, three trumpets, two baritone horns, which my father played baritone, and a trombone player. And then there was a bass drum player, a snare drum player, and a tuba player. What does it sound like? It sounds like a dirty dozen. A dirty dozen. And so every Monday night, we go there. And I was sitting next to Clifford. Didn't know who he was, what his stature was at that time. I just knew he was a good musician. Because I would sneak off and listen to him try this when he went. And anyway, that's how I grew up. I was about 12 years old. And I was able to just absorb all that richness from Clifford. And didn't know who he was. And then later on, I heard him on the radio one day. And it was really something to hear Clifford, Red Rodney, and Fats Navarro. Well, you don't have too many jazz aficionados in here. Otherwise, everybody was screaming off.
Hey, Red Rodney.
Because they were the cream of the crop of trumpet players. And so, when I heard them on the radio, and they announced their names, my father was doing something else. I said, Dad, that's the fellow that I sit next to in Wilmington. So I didn't know, but I became enamored by him, and I stuck to him like rice. White on rice, that is. And that was, we played in the old folks' home. In Wilmington one day. And so Clifford put his mute in, and when he put his mute in, started improvising over this song. And the song was Some of These Days. Anybody in here know that song?
Yeah.
I mean, you have to be over 60 to know that. Some of these days you're gonna miss me, honey. One of these days you're gonna miss my loving. You're gonna miss my kissing. You know, it's just a beautiful song. And Clifford put this mute in and played, and that was the most gorgeous thing in there. I couldn't play anymore, and I started crying. And so ever since then, I've been following the Brown. So anyhow, that's why I came into this music. That's one of the reasons why I stayed. And this is a song that I wrote for him. It's a few years ago. And this is going to feature our bassist, Mr. Ibrahim Jones.